Hi, hello, namaste. In our last section, we stated Bio-Savart's law, wherein the Bio-Savart's law stated that a differential magnetic field intensity at a point in a space was proportional to the current and the current element, the sine of the angle made by the current element to that of the point P, the line joining the point P, and it was inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the current element and the point P where I am finding the magnetic flux intensity. So with this, let us further go ahead with the concept of magnetic field. So this was also discussed. If I say this is the conductor, the blue line, whatever we are seeing here is a conductor. Okay, and the current flowing through the conductor is from the bottom to the top, and if you hold the conductor in your right hand, your thumb finger actually represents the flow of current, so your other fingers other than the thumb, which is curled around that particular cable or wire, will represent the direction of flux around that particular conductor. Or else there is another analogy wherein you have a screw where the tip of the screw corresponds to the flow of current, and if you want to tighten up the screw, you will be rotating that screw in a clockwise direction. So that particular rotation of that particular corkscrew will represent the flow of magnetic field around it, or the direction of that flow of the magnetic field. So this was the equation which we had derived in our last video lecture, and from this we'll be going to the further concept. So we have various forms of current elements. If you try to what you have to do is, like, whenever we are speaking about the magnetostatics, try to compare that with electrostatics so that you will be getting a proper comparison. In electrostatics, if you remember, there were various types of charges. Can you name them? Pause the video, take a pen, write down the different types of point charges or charges that you had come across there. Different types of charges. So I gave out an answer, a hint. One is point charge, okay? So if you have written, let's check it out. So there are different types of charges. Those are point charge, line charge, then good, sheet charge and volume charge. Sometimes the sheet charge is also called as surface charge, right? So this is the things that we had seen in our electrostatics. Similarly to this, we have line current, surface current and volume current in our magnetostatics. So with that, if I want to explain a line current is a current due to the line element. So this small length which we are considering, these are called as DL. DL are usually called as current elements. Okay, current element. So because of this, if I want to calculate the effect of magnetic field at some point here, so the current is flowing from bottom to top, hence if I hold this wire in my right hand, the flux will be coming out of this particular screen in the left hand side of the cable, and it will be penetrating through the right hand side. So I can represent something like this in my right hand side, and I can represent something like this in the left hand side, where left hand side represent the vector coming out of the screen, where this right hand side represent the vector going into the screen. Okay, so I hope you know this two concepts also. So if I say this is a vector and this is the back of the vector or an arrow, if you see from this point, so if you see from this point, So you are seeing only the tip or the pointed tip of that particular vector. So if you see from this point or from the back of that particular vector, okay, I'm very bad at drawing, but bear with me. If you see at this point, so you'll be seeing the feather of this particular vector, which looks something like this. Okay, so that's the concept about this. So to calculate the magnetic field intensity at a point due to line element or a current element, which is in the form of line current, it is simply nothing but IdL cross the unit vector AR cap divided by 4 pi R square. So this is for line element, okay? It is as simple as that. So this is the line element. So for a surface current, if you see a current flowing through a surface material, or if I take a material and current is flowing only on the surface, then what I'll be doing is I'll be considering a differential surface on that particular material. Okay, I'll be representing that differential surface something like this, ds, and current is represented as k. Okay, so then the surface current density can be written as the magnetic field intensity at a point due to surface current, can be simply written as k times ds cross the unit vector AR, that is the line joining the sheet and that particular point P. So if I say this is a point P where I'm finding, so the distance between this sheet and this point, if I represent that with a unit vector AR, so that is what that AR represents, divided by 4 pi R square. So this is just a fraction. DH is nothing but an incremental magnetic field. That incremental is because of this. If you want to know the magnetic field at this point due to this whole sheet, okay, due to this whole sheet, if you want to know, then what should I do? I should simply integrate this across that whole sheet, right? Similarly, if I want to know for the whole line, then I have to integrate this. So I just forgot to tell that. Keep that in mind. Okay, so this is for line current, this is for surface current, and the last one is for volume current. If I consider a volume wherein this is the volume that I have considered, you can see here the volume. Okay, so the current or the magnetic field intensity at a point P, if this is my point P, what is a magnetic field can be simply taken up by the current density. So integration of the whole volume you can think of. So it is J dot dV cross AR cap, where J is my current density, okay, divided by 4 pi R square. So this is the relation between my magnetic field intensity and the different forms of current elements. So this is for a volume current. If I want to calculate for a volume current, then I can simply use this particular equation. If I want to use for a surface current, where this is my surface charge that is flowing, so the K is the vector that the current vector, okay, the current vector that flows through on the surface, and here it is the line current. So these are the relations between, or these are the equations that can be used to find the electric field intent, I mean the magnetic field intensity, pardon me, the magnetic field intensity at a point P due to line current, surface current, and volume current. Hope this is understood. These are the various types of distributions of current. If you have any doubts or any queries, just feel free to drop in your comment or drop in a text to me. थैंक यू।